डियर स्टूडेंट्स, फिगर शोज अ फोर पोल नाइन स्लॉट मशीन दैट इज पी इज इक्वल टू फोर एंड नाइन स्लॉट्स आर देयर यू मे काउंट 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 एंड वी आर गोइंग टू कनेक्ट द क्वाइल एंड्स ऑफ द वेरियस क्वाइल्स प्लेस्ड इन द रोटर स्लॉट्स to the commutator segments. We are going to connect the coil ends to the commutator segments so as to form a double layer progressive simplex wave winding. So in double layer winding, number of coils will be equal to number of slots. So we will have 9 coils, and as we know that with each commutator segment, 2 coil sides are connected. So total number of coil sides will be double of number of coils, that is 9 into 2. So if 2 coil sides are connected with each commutator segment, so number of commutator segments will be equal to half of the total number of coil sides, that is number of coils, that is number of slots. So these will be also 9 in number, 9 commutator segments. In our previous discussions, we have discussed how to connect the coil ends with the commutator segments to form a simplex wave winding. So let us take any coil so in simplex wave winding, the 2 coil ends are connected with the commutator segments. Let us say this is 1. So this, the other one, suppose this is 1, this is 1 dash, the other way end will be connected with the commutator segment YC plus 1, where YC is commutator pitch, and so on. Again, this will be connected with the next coil side. We will see in detail. So what is YC? YC is commutator pitch. In case of simplex wave winding, this is given by 2 by P C plus minus 1. So plus sign is taken for progressive winding and minus sign is taken for retrogressive winding, where C is number of coils. So here in double layer, number of coils are same as that of the number of slots. So C is 9 here. So we may write for our case, for 4 pole, 2 by 4. And for progressive, let us take plus sign. So C is 9 plus 1. That is 10 by 4, 20 by 4. That is coming out to be 5. So if this is segment number 1, so this will be 5 plus 1. That is equal to 6, and so on. What about coil span? So for this, first find out the pole pitch. So pole pitch will be slot per pole, that is 9 by 4, that is coming out to be 2.25. So let us take our coil span. This is fractional, so let us take an integral value. So is equal to 2. So 2 slots will be our coil span. Suppose if this is coil number 1 placed in some slot, any slot, then after 2 slot the other coil end will be placed. So we will say that the coil span is equal to 2 slots, right? So taking care of these parameters, coil span and the commutator pitch, we are going to connect the 2 coil ends of any coil to the various commutator segment. So first mark the segments. So let us mark the segments 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. So we have 9 commutator segments, and let us show the coil sides in each slot. So we have 2 coil sides. So first show the top coil side positions of various coils, and then bottom coil sides of other coils. Let us mark with me. We will draw the developed diagram as in case of lap winding, similar to that for wave winding, right? Mark the various coil sides, start from anywhere. So 1, this is 2, this is 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we have total 9 coils. So if coil number 1 is placed here, so let us connect it with commutator 1. Where is commutator 1? Okay, so connect with this commutator. So we have connected one coil side of coil 1 with commutator 1. So where will be the other coil side of coil 1 be placed? So let us find out the slot where this will be placed. So we have two slots per pole. So coil span is two slots. So this is one. So one slot, two slots. It means this will be one dash. So we have discussed that in double layer, if one coil side is placed at top position, so other coil side will be placed at the bottom position, right? So we can say that the coil span is two slot, one slot, two slot from here. And then connect it with this. So we have our commutator pitch as 5. So this will be 6. So 6 is here, right? So this will be connected with 6 so that the difference will be 1 plus 5 will be equal to 6. So this will be connected with 6. Fine. Now from 6, which coil side will be connected? So if we have connected one with commutator segment 1, so with 6 commutator segment 6 will be connected. Fine. So the other coil side of commutator segment 6, so we have coil span of 2 slot, so 6 dash will be 1 slot, 2 slot, so 6 dash will lie here. This will be 6 dash. So where to connect the other coil end of 6? So we have to make a difference of 5 commutator segments. So 6 plus 5, this will be 11, but we have 9. So it means 2. So this will be, you can count from here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 5th one, right? Similar to that. See here. How many segments between 1 and 6? 2, 3, 4, 5. That is 4 segments, right? So take a difference of 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5th one. So we will connect this with 5th one, right? So similar to that, with 2, if 1 is connected with 1, 6 is connected with 6, so 2, we will connect the second one. Fine. So where the second coil side of coil 2 will lie? So after a span of 2 slots, so this will be 2 dash. And make a difference of, again, 5, commutator pitch is 5, so 5 plus 2, 7, that is, this will be connected with 7, right? Again, 7 is connected with commutator segment 7, so the other coil side of 7 will be having a span of 2 slots, so this will be 7 dash. So again, add 7 plus 5, 12. So that will be 9 plus 3, 12. So third, this will go into third commutator segment. Right? Again, coil side 3 will be connected with commutator segment 3. So the other coil end of 3 will be having a span of 2 coils, 2 slots. So this will be 3 dash. So if this is connected with 3, make a difference of 5 commutator segments. So 3 plus 5, 8. So this will be connected with 8. This will be connected with 8. Fine. So again, 8th will be connected 8th coil side will be connected, one coil side of coil 8 will be connected with commutator segment 8. So where the next coil side will lie? 8 dash. So after two slot, after a span of two slots, so this will be 8 dash. So where will it be connected? So if this is connected with 8, so make a difference of 5 commutator segment, 13. So 13 means 9 plus 4, 13. So 4th, this will be connected with 4th. Again connect the 4th coil with 4th commutator segment. So the other coil end of coil number 4 will be having a span of 2 slot. So this will be 4 dash, bottom position. So where 4 dash will be connected? So 4 plus 5, that is 9. So it will be connected with 9. Right? So again, with 9th commutator segment, the one coil end of 9th coil will be connected. So what about other coil end? A span of 2. So that is here, 9 dash. So if this is connected with 9, so other will be connected with 9 plus 5, that is, this is the end one, so 5th one, right? So connect it with 5th. Again, with 5th commutator segment, the 5th coil, one end of 5th coil is connected. So what about the other end? After a span of 2, so this will be 5 dash. So if 5 is connected with 5, so the next will be 5 plus 5, 10, that is first. So this will be connected with 1. So this way, we have seen that we started from 1. We started from 1 and we have terminated at 1 itself. So this commutator segment shorts these two close. So this way also, this wave winding is also a completely closed winding. Fine. This we are talking about progressive. That's why we are connecting the next end ahead of the first end. Right. Suppose the rotor of our generator is being rotated in anti-clockwise direction. Let us say omega. So what will be the EMF induced in various? We can find out. Let us find here. So tangential velocity will be this way. What is B? So take V cross B, right? So what will be V cross B? To take the polarity, right? So V cross B outward, right? This is coming out to be outward. So dot will be there. Fine. Similarly, under north, this is not lying under north or south. This is lying along the magnetic neutral axis. So this will not induce any EMF. Fine. What about this? Under north, so dot will be there. So under south, cross will be there. You may check with the help of V cross B. South, cross will be there. Under north, dot will be there. Dot will be there. This is south. So cross will be there. Cross will be there. Cross will be there. Cross will be there. So no dot or cross. Why? Because at this moment of time, corresponding to the position of rotor shown in figure, no EMF will be induced in these two coil sides. Coil sides 9 and 7. That is one coil side of this and other 7, right? So let us mark the positions. We can mark the current direction also, right? So dot means current is entering here. So this way, this is also dot. So into, right? This is dot. So into, this is cross. So directions will be like this, right? This is also cross. This is also cross. This is dot. This is dot. This is dot. This is cross. Fine, just check it. This is dot. This is cross. And this is cross. This is also cross. No direction here and no direction here. We have marked all the current directions, right? So we may observe that starting from any point, say 1, so current goes to coil side 5 dash, then from 5 dash it goes to 5. So where is 5? This. So from 5 it goes to commutator segment this, and here we can collect the current, because from both the coil sides connected to this commutator segment current is coming. See, in other coil segments, here current is coming then leaving. Here both the currents are leaving, so one brush can be placed here itself. Here current coming, leaving. Here current coming, so here also one brush can be placed. We will discuss in detail. So in commutator segment 1, coming, leaving. So we will discuss all these directions in a developed diagram. Let us draw one developed diagram. So draw with me. Let us take a cut from here, slot number 1, or anywhere from 9, anywhere. From anywhere we can make a cut. And better take some 1, 2, 3. Okay, so let us start Let us make it with me 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let us make one more here. So these are the various slots. So if we are going to start with 9, so we can mark this as 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Again 9. The 9 is repeated. The same 9 is here, right? So let us place the conductors. Top layer coil sides, and bottom layer coil sides. Fine. So let us represent. I am using blue and black instead of red and green. I am going to use blue and black in order to get more intensity. So let us draw the solid lines first. So we have drawn the solid lines corresponding to the top coil sides placed at the top positions of the slots, right? Let us mark. So this is 9, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, again 9. So let us draw for bottom coil sides, represented by dotted line. So at 9, bottom is 7, right? This is basically 7 dash. 6 dash, 7 dash, right? Okay, so just mark it 7 dash. This is bottom of 1 is 8 dash. Then 9 dash. You can check here 2, then 9 dash, 3, 1 dash. Then 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash, and again 7 dash. So 9, 7 dash, right? So this will be 7 dash, this will be 8 dash, this will be 9 dash. The bottom coil side is represented by dotted line. This will be 1 dash. This will be 2 dash. This will be 3 dash. This will be 4 dash. This will be 5 dash. This will be 6 dash. And finally, this will be 7 dash. Fine. At the same time, let us draw the segments, commutator segments. So I am going to draw with this color, green color. I think you can see it. Fine. So let us mark the segments. So this is 1, right? So this segment, before that 1 is there. So before that, this is 1, this is 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, again 1 and 2, like that. Before that 2 is there. So we can connect the one end of coil 1 is connected with segment 1. So this is 1, segment 1. So this 1 is connected with this. Let us represent the back end connection. Let us show the back end connection. So back end, from back side, from back end, the 1 will be connected with the other coil side, 1 dash. Fine. Then 1 dash is connected after 5, commutator pitch was 5. So after 5, 6 will be there. We can observe from here itself. So 1 dash is connected with 6. So this is 1 dash. So this will be connected with 6. So this will be connected with 6. This time we are going to design wave winding, right? 6. Again, with 6, the 6 is connected. So connect this. From back end, 6 will be connected with 6 dash. So connect it. Right? Again, 6 is connected. 6 dash. So 6 dash is connected with 2. So this is 2. So 6 dash will be connected with 2. You may observe that the wave-like shape is being formed. That's why the name wave winding is called wave winding, right? So we have reached till 2. So from 2, the next coil end is connected, right? From 2, second coil end is connected, right? So from 2, 2 is connected, right? We started from 1, then going through this came 2, then again 2. We have not completed the loop, right? So 2 will be connected with 2 dash from back end. So connect this 2 dash, and 2 dash is connected with 7, right? See here, 2 dash is connected with 7. So connect with 7 this 2 dash, and 7 is connected with 7, and 7 is connected with 7 dash from back end. So this is 7 dash, and 7 dash is connected with 7 dash. This is 7, so this is 7 dash. So 7 dash is connected with 3. So connect it with 3. So 7 dash is here. And with 3, the third is connected, coil side 3 is connected, and coil side 3 is connected with coil side 3 dash from the back end. Again, 3 dash is connected with 8. So 3 dash is connected with 8. So this is 3 dash. Connect with 8. Now from 8, the 8th one is connected. Coil side number 8 is connected. Coil 8 is connected with 8 dash from the back side, back end. So this is going to 8 dash. So where is 8 dash? Here it is 8 dash. So 8 dash is connected. This is 8 dash with 4. So this is 4, and 8 dash is connected with 4. So again, coil side 4 is connected with 8 dash. So this is coil side 4 connected with this commutator segment 4, 8 dash and 4. See here, 8 dash and 4 is connected. 4 is connected with 4 dash from back side. So this is 4 dash connected with 4 dash. 4 dash is connected with 9. So 4 dash is connected with 9. And 9 is connected with coil side number 9. Right? So connect it with this. We can check it from segment 9. 4 dash and 9 are connected. From 9, 4 dash and 9 are connected. Again, 9 is connected with 9 dash from back end. So where is 9 dash? This is 9 dash. So here, this is 9 dash. And 9 dash is connected with commutator segment 5. So commutator segment 5 is there. And 9 dash is connected with 5. Again with 5, the coil side number 5 is connected. So connect this. 5 is connected with 5 dash from the back end. So connect this. And 5 dash finally is connected with 5 dash is connected with 1. So this is 1. and 5 dash is connected with 1, and the other coil side is 1. It started from here. This is the first one, right? So this way we can observe that we started from 1. This is the same part of this repetition of this, because this is circular in shape. So we have cut from anywhere and we have taken the developed diagram, shown as developed diagram. So let us mark the poles. So at this moment of time, when rotor position is like that, like this, so we may observe that coil sides 1 8 dash and 2 9 dash lie along north pole. 1 8 dash and 2 9 dash, these are lying along north pole. Fine. 1 and 2, and 3 1 dash and 4 2 dash along south pole. 3 1 dash. So basically our pole pitch is 2.2, not exactly 2 slots, right? So this will be slightly more, right? So start from here and show some extended one, right? This pole pitch is not basically 2 slot, this is 2.25 slot per pole, right? So this is south. Again, these two lie along north, 3 dash 5, 5 3 dash and 6 4 dash, right? North, and again 7 5 dash 8 6 dash, 7 5 dash 8 6 dash lie along north south pole, right? This is south. And what about ninth coil side 9 and 7 dash? Coil side 9 and 7 dash, you may observe that at this moment of time these two coil sides lie along magnetic neutral axis, hence no EMF is induced, right? Let us mark the current directions. Suppose load is connected, current is flowing. So let us mark the, we will show it later. So let us mark the current direction in various coil sides. So in this coil side, this is front end, commutator end. See, current is coming, so this will be shown downward, right? So let us show it downward. Here in south pole, upward. Here downward. Here upward. Upward. No current direction, no EMF induced in coil side 9 and 7 dash at this moment of time, right? After a while, once it will enter, we are rotating counterclockwise, so once it will enter, so EMF will be induced and accordingly sign will be given. But this will enter along magnetic neutral axis, so no EMF will be induced once it lie along any magnetic neutral axis, right? So at this moment of time, let us mark the directions. So this is this. So this is this. What about this? This. And what about this? This. Similarly for this. So let us mark this direction, this direction. Fine. What about this? This direction. What about this? This direction. For this, let us mark this direction. For this, let us mark this direction. For these two coil sides, this direction, this direction. For these two coil sides, this direction, this direction. For these two coil sides, this direction and this direction. Fine. So we have marked the coil sides. Now where to place the brushes? So we, in order to collect the current, we will place the brushes at suitable positions discussed earlier. So here, see, current is coming and leaving. The same current is coming and leaving, so no current here, so can't be collected at this moment of time through this commutator segment. At this, from both the coil sides, current is entering. So here we may place one brush, and we are talking about DC generator, so current leaving means supply, so mark it plus mark. Here current is coming and leaving, no current here. Here you can observe current is leaving, so you may mark current direction this, and you may place one more brush here. So current is leaving, so you may mark minus sign. Suppose load is connected here, so you may connect the terminals, and this will be armature current flowing through this. Fine. Now we have connected the coil ends to the commutator segment to form the simplex wave winding. In wave winding, we have only two parallel paths independent of the number of poles. Now let us start. Start from anyone. So here we have two paths. So take the right path first. So current goes to 7, then 7 dash. So come to 7 dash. 7 dash is this. So it goes to 4. So 4 dash. Then, though no EMF is induced, but this will provide path for this current, right? So this current will flow, will get path through this, because through this no path is there. This commutator segment is insulated with this segment, and this is insulated with this segment, and no brush is connected. So this current is bound to flow through this. So 4 dash, then this will be 9. Though EMF is not induced at this moment of time, but if current is there, the path will be there for this current, right? Right, 9. So 9, where is 9? So 9 goes to 9 dash. So 9 dash and enters here. So we have seen one path starting from here till this other brush position, starting from one brush position to the other brush position. Now let us take the second path. So this is 2 dash, it goes to 2, and 2 goes to commutator segment 2, that is 6 dash, then 6, then it goes to 1 dash, then it goes to 1, then segment 1. So from 1, 5 dash, 5, and finally it enters to this brush segment. So we can say that we have two parallel paths. That's why only two brushes are required in case of wave winding. But we may place as many number of brushes as number of poles in wave winding. If we wish, we can place. For large machines, generally number of brushes are more than 2 because of several other advantages. Advantage number 1, it improves commutation. It improves reliability. Suppose if you are having only 2 brushes, if one brush failed, then we can't collect the current. But if we have more than one brush, then we can collect from other brushes. So that is one of the advantages of having more than 2 brushes. Though only 2 brushes are required in case of wave winding, but because of several other advantages, generally the number of brushes may be equal to number of poles in case of wave winding also. Maybe, not necessarily. In case of lap winding, it is necessary to place the number of brushes equal to number of poles, but in case of wave winding only 2 brushes are required, but we may place more than 2 depending upon the number of poles, right? So if you wish to place, here we have 4 poles, so 2 more brushes can be placed, right? If you want, you can place. So one of the advantages, it improves commutation, it increases reliability, and third one is it reduces the current through a particular brush. If we have more number of brushes, so current division will be among the various brushes. So if you wish to place brushes, So brushes may be placed one pole pitch apart. So leaving this, you may observe. You can collect this current through this also. You may collect. So this will be this direction. So mark plus. If you wish, so 1, 2, 2. This is nearly equal to one pole pitch. So here you may observe that this is leaving through this. So this is leaving. So this will be minus. So if you wish, you may. So let us connect the negative terminals together and positive terminals together. Fine. So this way we have seen the simplex lap winding and simplex wave winding in detail. If you have any other question, just type in comment box. Thank you very much.